Whew. Raining out. Everything's getting wet. I'm gonna have to batten her down. The wind's coming from behind. Typically I would be, if I was at anchor, I'd be bowing to the wind. Not everything would be soaking wet back there. I dropped the canvas, so I'll cut that down a little bit. The weather this day had me especially concerned, not just because it was blowing hard, but because all of a sudden it shut down as if we were in the eye of a storm. To say it was eerie doesn't really do it justice. It was dead calm a second ago. Probably looks dead calm. But there's flags over there. Stuff over there. Look at the clouds, eh? It's strange because the weather did a 180. It was coming from over there earlier, and now it's coming from that direction. I'm getting a lot of warnings on the phone, too, about the horrific weather that's afoot. Skies are really talking. Sounds like a line from Twister or something. But for real. Something tells me within moments, this relative calm is potentially going to turn into something really gnarly. I'm a big believer in trusting your gut. If it says to pay attention, you should probably pay attention. This weather is sick. It was calm there, like we've just seen. And now, wind is howling. Now the wind's coming this direction. It was there, and then it was over there, and now it's coming from over here. Golly. Wicked weather. In this nonsense. Wow. The flag over there on that pole looks like it's about to be torn off. Absolutely outrageous. Goes. shit unfurls, it's gonna be dirty.
Man, he's about to lose a lot of money to canvas.
Yep.
Say goodbye, canvas. Wow.
Shit gets ugly quick around here, doesn't it?
Next to him.
Back in July when I parked this boat, it seemed like the weather was constantly acting up like this, so taking a break from traveling seemed like a very wise thing to do. This rather exposed marina here in Oriental, North Carolina, kind of gives you a sense of what it's like to be on the water. I'm just gonna let it play out, and maybe you get why I decided to stop for a while. Not just for me, but for the boat, and for everything else that I hold dear. Everything seems like a chore when the wind is blowing like this and you're living on a boat. Whether it's walking the dogs, or getting groceries, or doing laundry. After 6 straight months of living on a boat, I was ready for a change. So here you go, here's 10 minutes. Of what I experienced during that time.